Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX Product Marketing team, and today we are going to be exploring where important settings and preferences can be found for running NX in managed mode. Having your system set up to function in a workflow that fits your needs is extremely important for efficient work. In this video, we will dive into the most common settings and preferences you may want to look at, and what each one specifically means for your product and design needs. The first key area for settings that is important to explore for Managed Mode in NX can be found under the File tab in Utilities under Customer Defaults. Here we can find an enormous number of settings that can be used to optimize your designs and workflows. This may be overwhelming at first, but the left-hand side is organized by application. For today's purposes, we are just going to be investigating the Managed Mode settings. When the Team Center Integration tab is opened, we can see that there are a wide variety of settings to choose from. In the Save tab, we can explore a number of settings for when we are saving data that can enhance our experience as users. This option here at the top encourages parts and assemblies to be saved more frequently. Another group of settings that is important to look at inside of Customer Defaults can be found under the Multiple Revisions tab. Here, we can opt if we would like to allow multiple revisions, and also choose if and when revisions are checked for. It is important to note that customer defaults control the initial settings and parameters for NX at the site, group, and user levels. Next, we will look at preferences for managed mode in NX. Preferences are more tailored for the individual experience. Customer defaults are typically used at the administrative level, while preferences may change from user to user. As we select Team Center Integration, a large window will open containing some of the most popular settings from customer defaults. The first section we will specifically look at is the checkout and check-in policy options we have. On larger projects and assemblies, the best way to attack new design updates is by checking out individual parts to make changes. Here we have the option to customize when these parts are checked out and when they are checked back in. Often it is convenient to check out parts upon modification to avoid overlap with other team members who may be working on the same part. Additionally, for checking in parts, it may make more sense to wait until the part is closed if you frequently save your workflows as you go. The second place we are going to look is under the User Settings section of the Team Center Integration Preferences. Here, we have a few more important options to select before beginning. Under the Organization tab is an option called Default Group. This is where we can find the team we are working on in our company or organization. This should be the group that you typically work on during your everyday projects. At times during large projects, you may have to help out on other assignments across your organization. An example of this could be a designer on an engineering team who needs to help with a technical drawing for an assembly. Making this change within NX can easily be made under the Session category here in User Settings. As you can see, we can quickly change teams and now begin our work creating our drawings. In conclusion, in this video, we've explored a number of preferences and settings for our workflows using Managed Mode in NX. We specifically focused on some of the basic decisions for setting up your approach to completing different tasks, discussing save options, multiple revisions, checkout and check-in policies, and user settings. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.